Thank you for joining this episode of The Blade Boys. I'm Ted Flett.
And I'm Mitt Das.
And we're here to go back in time a little bit and do a recap of the pairs event and the ice dancing event at 2015 Skate America. And Myth, you know, we didn't see any world champions in either discipline. Let's start off with the pairs. And I actually think that's kind of nice because there's a bit more possibility for variety in terms of the results and who finishes atop the podium and who really stands out. So this, of course, was won by the Chinese team of Sui and Han, the reigning world silver medalists, who had a breakthrough season last season. And of course stepped atop the podium. And from the sounds of things, and based on what we saw at Skate America, they are well on their way to hold their own and try and remain on the podium and perhaps even in the silver medal position or higher. I was really impressed by their skates. What were your thoughts? What did you think?
I thought Sui and Han, like, I really love their programs this year. Like, that goes without saying. I especially love their short program this year. I think it's intense, it's got this fieriness to it, and it's something that it's a side of them we haven't seen. She's got a little, you know, Zhenya Stolbova haircut and her little Megan Duhamel hair, so she's going with the short hair, so she's, you know, she's ready to, you know, give face and keep it real that way. But their short program unfortunately had a major error, which was their Paris combo spin, and they've been doing this particular Paris combo spin for a while now, and it's very risky, like the first part of it, and sometimes it gets invalidated because of how risky it is. And in this case, it did affect their placement in the short program. However, their free program, they totally killed it. Like, they ended up winning in fine fashion. I mean, they still made some errors here and there. I mean, some uncharacteristic errors, like on like the second, I think it was the second side by side jump, like it was like downgraded or something like that. So they had some errors. They weren't.
Wait, yeah, he went. I think he went down like a ton of bricks, if I recall correctly.
Yeah, and
he didn't get the proper rotation and just went like splat right forward. You could almost see him laugh and sort of brush it off as he resumed.
She wasn't laughing. She was.
she was like, not this again. Like,
Still, they like landed a fabulous quad twist to open up their program, and they really cemented themselves and proved why they are the world silver medalists. You said there were no reigning world champions, but like last year, they did score like over 215 points at the world, so it was very much like the caliber of a world champion from last year. So good for them for starting off their season right.
I like that she's really showing a lot more fieriness this season. She's got the short, sassy haircut, and she really is seeming to come into her own in terms of her presence on the ice.
There's a lot more attack.
There is. I was disappointed that they didn't go for the throw quad Sauka, which was looking really strong in practice. Apparently, they thought that because there was like an early practice day or an early practice session that day, that they didn't feel like it was, you know, that they could get it in there. And I thought, it doesn't really wash with me. I think if you're going to go for quad, if you want to compete with Megan and Eric, you know, what happens if hypothetically at the World Championships, it's an early morning practice session and then you got to compete? Like, I think they should have gone for it. It was a beautiful throw, you know, Sauka nonetheless. And I think it's in the run-up towards the Grand Prix final, when likely they will go head-to-head with Duhamel Radford and with Velocichar and Trankov, that they want to have that trick well under their belt. But nonetheless, I mean, strong programs, and she is looking great.
Yeah, no, they're looking very sharp already this season, so that's a good sign. And of course, you're right. We have to talk about
Americans. Like, what an awesome, because they won the short program. Alexa Skimeka and Chris Kniro, with, of course, Nothing Else Matters. Nothing Else Matters than winning the short program, and that's what they did. they looked hot. I mean, that short program, I think, is fantastic. You know, I love it. I love when the music comes on. I love all the transitions between the three vocalists in the music. I think it's just a great, great vehicle for them to ideally, you know, maybe make the top four, top five in the world. It's all got to be one on the short. Well, it's not one on the short program, but you definitely have to set yourself apart in the short. And I think this program really does that. What did you think of the short program?
I thought it was a really great short program. They did have the error on the side-by-side triple sow cows, which was you know, not something they usually do. Like, they're like, especially Chris, he's usually very consistent with that. Unfortunately, in the free skate, the side-by-side jumps were a huge problem for both of them. But like Sui and Han, they had a gorgeous quadruple twist to open. And hey, what better confidence than to like win that short program? I don't think they were expecting it. I think they went into it with a lot of attack. They showed a lot of fire that some of the other teams were a bit tentative, and they really came out of the gates blazing. I thought they were very expressive to that program, sometimes a little bit too expressive, like maybe Alexa's expressions were a bit over the top. But that being said, like, it's rock and roll, baby. Like, you gotta go big or go home. So, I mean, yeah. Alexa, as we know, she knows how to rock out, and that short program definitely proved it. But that, then again, that's what I love about their programs for this team, because their free program showed this regal sophistication with Elizabeth the Golden Age. And other than the side-by-side jumps, they actually did a really good job. And of course, when you manage to hold off like some other tough competitors, who we'll talk about shortly, it's a really good sign. And I think Alexa, even on her social media, she said, oh, we're like, they were hoping for a bronze and that would have been great. But hey, now they've got a silver, and silver puts you in contention for one of those Grand Prix final spots. If you manage to come second or third with a tiebreaker, you can make it to the Grand Prix final. And wouldn't that be exciting to see an American Paris team back at the Grand Prix final? I mean, it's been a while, but yeah, I think Alexa and Chris could be the ones to do it. And I think they even surprised themselves with how well they did here at this competition.
Yeah, I mean, I gotta say, I think they're gonna need to skate the long program exceptionally clean, because it's taking, for me anyways, it's taking me a while to warm up to that program. I think the short program is more dynamic, it's more fiery, I think it suits them a bit more, frankly, and it's easier to sell that program, even if there is an error. I think the free skate is a bit more ethereal, it's a bit more introspective, it's harder to sort of get in there, and so hopefully they'll, with more miles on it. But yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, I think they're in good shot to make the Grand Prix final and probably prevent a few other teams that might have been, might have been favored for that. So moving sort of down the podium, the Canadians, of course, came third. Yeah, which is very exciting. I tell you, the Canadian competition, Nationals, is getting like more and more pressure packed with every competition that passes. What did you think? I mean, I think that Juliana and Charlie, after coming off sort of a subpar season opener at Nebelhorn, really turned it on at Skate America, and I think showed the strength of, this is what happens when you skate a clean short program, that it can ride you right till to the end of the comp and up onto the podium. But what did you think?
Well, I thought Julien and Charlie did an amazing job. I mean, you're right, after their initial Challenger Series kind of faux pas earlier on in the season, they came out swinging hard in this Grand Prix series. This is their senior debut for the Grand Prix, and to come out with a medal is a really huge accomplishment. And not just a medal, they were not all of their elements were crystal clean in their free skate, but they were the cleanest pair of this competition. They were cleaner than the world silver medalist. They were cleaner than the former world silver medalist. They were cleaner than the American U.S. champions. I think they really put some heat on the other Canadian teams, as you said, because right now, people are wondering who are going to be the number two and number three teams going into Worlds. And Julien and Charlie had an amazing Worlds last year as well to debut there. So this is a great start for them. They almost came second. I think arguably they could have come second, but I think it was Alexa and Chris's quadruple twist that cemented that silver medal. I mean, with the two falls, you could argue that the Canadians really were a lot cleaner. But with that addition of that quad twist, I think it can be justified that the Americans really did deserve second, especially that short program Again, like the Americans had a small error, the Canadians were clean, so you might argue that what's going on. But that being said, the Americans, they had that experience, they have more speed, they have more attack, and they had the quad twist and the freeze. So that was a very close, like second, third place thing, but great for Charlie and Julien for this like bronze. I'm sure they're very pleased with that. They look very pleased. I would be very pleased if on my senior debut I ended up getting a bronze at a Grand Prix event. So they should be very proud of themselves. And yeah, things are heating up come Canadian Nationals.
I mean, and of the things that I loved about their short program, I mean, I could totally imagine a team like them that, you know, are now really trying to enter the and make an impression at the senior ranks, to choose a short program music that might be a bit calmer and sort of let them sort of sink into the program and take deep breaths and, you know, keep their heart rate down and keep calm and focused. But they've chosen Cirque du Soleil for that short program, and it's like go right from the start, and it doesn't stop. I mean, listen to the music, and I think if that was me skating to that, I'd have had a heart attack in the first 30 seconds. So yeah. The fact that they have picked that music and they skate to it well, like they don't, it's not like they're trying to, you know, they're chasing the music, they're owning that music, and, you know, and it's tough. That was one of the things that I'm most impressed by in terms of their performances at Skate America and their programs this season. And of course, they upped the Russians. I mean, who would have thought that Stobova and Klimov would not make it onto the podium at Skate America? I mean, I thought they would have won this. I mean, I really thought, okay, Sween Han have the world silver medal, but now we're gonna, we're gonna get back to business and recalibrate, you know, how the rankings should be. Wow, what do we say about this team?
Well. Oh, Senya and Fedor. I mean, what can we say? Like, this event was a disaster for them. I mean, they had their Challenger Series event where they actually, like, kind of had a nice free skate other than the one major error. So that was kind of like a bit of a redemption thing. But this short program, like, something's going on with their throws where, like, the technique's off or the timing's off or they don't trust each other. Because, like, she went down on the throw, and, of course, like, even silly elements, like, the twist, like, was shaky. Like, these are, like, they are Olympic champions in the team event, and they are Olympic silver medalists and world silver medalists. Like, these are mistakes that, and they've had, like, an off season to sort of iron this stuff out. So these are mistakes that they can't afford at this point in time. They got beat by, like, the U.S. champions and the Canadian, like, bronze medalists, like, and who were like seventh and I think eighth or something at Worlds last year. So this is not a good outing for them. That being said, I'm very glad that the judges gave them this wake-up call, because I honestly thought that with their reputation, the Russians would actually end up getting boosted on the component scores onto the podium. But I'm very glad that didn't happen. It seems like the judging was a lot fairer. Again, like at Skate America, like judges are starting to award marks for cleaner skates. Like you see that with Medvedeva, with Max Aaron, right? Like these are skaters who aren't, you know, the most expressive skaters or the ones who are the most popular skaters. But they're actually
who have the strongest
resume, right? Like they don't have the credentials. Yeah. They don't have the, you know, Olympic silver medalist bonus that that Patrick Chan might get or that Stobova and Klimov might get, right? Like these are teams that are actually having to fight to skate cleanly. So when other teams like Stobova and Klimov have, like, for them was a disastrous short program. I mean, they really need to go back to the drawing board and figure themselves out, because, like, a fourth on the Grand Prix is not going to help. I mean, if they win their next event, it might go down to a tiebreaker, and even still, their score in this event wasn't that great. So they need to get themselves together by Russian nationals and Europeans. That should be their goal right now, and figuring themselves out, because even these programs, I'm like, I'm sorry, but there's just this, like, gloomy, sad aloofness to it. And like at the end, like Zenya's smiling and she's like, you know, more chipper, but I wish she would like inject some, they seem so focused and so like, oh my God, we can't screw this up, that like it's really detrimental to the performance. And I think it, and with errors on top of that, that's even worse. And this shows up in the components marks. I mean, their component scores were they were under 65 points in the free skate, which is not competitive at all with like Duhamel and Radford or Sui and Han. So they need to pick up their socks.
Yeah, I think that I'm hoping that there's some kind of a, there's some story that we're not aware of. There's some bigger picture piece that they're working towards. I do give them the fact that they haven't competed since European, so January of this year, whereas other teams have skated more recently. So maybe they're trying to find those competitive juices again and get comfortable in a competitive or competition setting. That could be happening. I give them full credit for the fact that it does appear as though they're sort of they're setting up or they've constructed the program so that they might go after haven't seen one in practice, but they're doing
Yeah,
quite
quad,
a few
yeah.
field moves before they go into that throw triple salchow. And it's now at the front of the program as opposed to the very final element, which makes me think they want to skate the quad on fresher legs and have lots of breathing room to get rid of it. They've ditched the double axels and they're doing the triple triple double combination and they're doing the triple salchows, which they did land the triple triple double,
They
which
and
was awesome.
that is
And
very notable because that is the first time in history that a pairs team has done side by side triple triple, in this case adding triple triple double. It's the first time that's ever happened.
yeah,
So that's so as bad as this competition was, I mean, still Stolbov and Klimov, you made
there were
history,
some
so
yeah. There
like
were some, yeah. There were
congratulations to
some
you
silver,
guys for that.
there were definitely some silver linings in there. Few and far
Well,
between, but there were
fourth
some.
place
And
landings.
I think that yeah, totally. And yeah, I mean, maybe I'm still hoping. I mean, I think this is definitely a world-class team. They don't seem in world-class shape right now, and these don't appear like world-class vehicles. The programs aren't really, inspiring me either. But it might be kind of a, Michelle Kwan skating to the Red Violin style program where you have to skate these things clean for them to come off. And so, only time will tell. But similarly, I mean, I probably at this point making the Grand Prix final is a might be a blessing in disguise because maybe they just need some additional time to train. They'll do one more Grand Prix hit and then hunker down for Russian nationals and ideally for the European Championships in the world. I think they should be on the world team. I mean, I think that they're that good when they're world class. I mean, when they skate clean, when they skate to their potential, I think they're world class and they should be there. But of course, it's Russia and there are lots of teams that that they're pushing and that are pushing them. So I think there's four or five teams that are all very capable and qualified for making that. I believe it's a three-member team.
Yes, yes.
And of course, the return of Velocichar and Trankov, which is like a never-ending theme on every Blade Boys episode. We have to talk about that. I mean, they've thrown everything kind of up in the air in terms of the state of affairs in Russia and Russian pairs because we all assume that they're just going to come in and it's going to be another coronation. So interesting times for Stubble and Klimov, but I'm a big fan, and hopefully they can. Hopefully they can get their act together.
Yep, and I think that was a very interesting pairs competition at Skate America to open off the Grand Prix season with a lot of, I mean, I expected Sui and Han to win. I didn't expect them. I expected them to win in fine form. I didn't expect them to like lose the short. I definitely didn't expect Sobo and Klimov to be off the podium. And much like Alexa, I'm sure I didn't expect her to place as high as silver. So good for them. And the Canadians was a wonderful surprise to see on put him, even though it was at the expense of the Russians who were having difficulties early on. But nevertheless, a great competition. We're going to move on to the ice dance competition of Skate America now, where we saw Chalk and Bates actually produce a brand new, I was about to say original dance, short dance. I'm still living in the 90s, okay?
There were good times. There were
There
good
were
times.
good. There were good
Get your
times.
leg warmers on, girl.
Yeah, I know. but yes, Chalk and Bates, they debuted a brand new short dance that they had actually only practiced or like ran through like 3 or 4 times. They've come up with a couple of short dance programs. I think they want to